Planking is, hands down, one of the best ways to put your core to the test. Unfortunately, it can quickly become one of the most boring. Hi viewers, and welcome back to Bestie! Planks offer a safe, challenging, and effective way to train both the core and many other muscles. These include the shoulders, pectorals, biceps, triceps, glutes, quads, hamstrings, and more. The best part is you can do it anywhere. It doesn't take any special coordination or equipment, and there are countless ways to vary it. With a series of quick tweaks, you can transform the humble plank into a whole array of new muscular challenges to finally build those six-pack abs you've been after. In today's video, we'll tell you the best plank variations that will take your abs workout to the next level. From reverse plank, rocking plank, lateral plank walk, plank jack to reach plank and more. Watch till the end to learn about all of them. Number 1. Knee plank. This plank builds strength and stability in the core muscles, including the back and deep layers like the transverse abdominis. This is a great starting place if you're coming back from an injury or extended time away from physical activity. Start on all fours. Place your forearms parallel to each other on the floor with your elbows directly below your shoulders. Gently walk back your knees until your torso and upper legs form a straight line from your knees to your shoulders. Engage your core and your glutes to hold this position for as long as you can. Keep your neck in line with your spine and your hips level and square. No arching, sagging, or tilting. Is plank a regular part of your workout? Tell us quickly down below in the comment section. Number 2, high plank. This is a great exercise for beginners. It requires you to place your palms on the ground instead of the forearm, making it easier. It works on muscle groups such as the core, hips, legs, arms, and shoulders. Start sitting on your knees and place your hands on the ground shoulder width apart, with your arms straight directly underneath your shoulders. Put your legs behind you to get into a push-up position. Make sure your weight stays on your hands and toes. Engaging your core, focus on abdominal muscles and hold for 30 to 60 seconds, depending on your strength. Number 3, forearm plank. If a high plank is too tricky for you or you just want to adjust and try a modification, go for the forearm plank. To get into it, lie on your stomach on a mat. From there, rest your body on your bent forearms with legs out straight behind you, toes tucked in. Keep your forearms on the ground while the rest of your body lifts. Your elbows should be right underneath your shoulders. Everything should remain in a straight line. Keep your back and core straight with your belly button pulled in towards the spine. Do it for 30 seconds at first and then increase the timing. Number 4, reverse plank. Like other plank variations, the reverse plank also strengthens the core and tones muscles, but at the same time works different muscles such as the lower back, quads, glutes, and the abductor. Sit on your butt, legs straight in front of you. Put your hands on the ground at your sides, fingers forward. Now push up until your arms are extended and make sure they're below your shoulders so your body forms a straight line. Brace your abdominal muscles and hold the position for 30 to 60 seconds. Number 5, rocking plank. Incorporating a rocking plank helps build a stronger core, will flatten your stomach, and increase mobility. Get into a normal position with your forearms slightly shorter than shoulder width apart and below your chest. Keep your back straight and maintain a straight line from your head to the heels. Make sure your weight stays on your hands and toes only. Now tighten your core and slowly move your upper body forward by rising higher onto your toes until your shoulders cross the fingertips. Then slowly move to the opposite direction to get back to the starting position. Do this for as long as you can. Have I caught your interest? Well then hit that subscribe button to watch more videos. Join our millions of followers for more amazing Bestie content. Number 6, side plank. Once you get used to the standard plank, try a side plank, an excellent exercise for working the sides of your core. This type of plank is unilateral and great for the back in general. It strengthens the obliques and deep spinal stabilizing muscles as well as hips and shoulders. For these, you'll start on your side. Prop up on your bottom elbow with your hand out in front of you for balance. The elbow should be directly under your shoulder. Next, stack your legs and bring them together so your heels touch. Lift your hips into the air by squeezing your core and glutes. If you feel balanced, try lifting your top arm towards the ceiling. Otherwise, you can rest it on your top hip. Repeat the move on the other side. To modify, keep your bottom knee on the ground for extra support. Number 7, star forearm plank. This is an advanced variation of the side plank. It targets your core, glute, abductor, external and internal obliques, and biceps. Lie down on your right side and hold your upper body up by placing your elbow and forearm on the floor perpendicular to your upper arm with the palms flat on the floor. Keep your leg straight with your left foot on top of the right. Lift your hips and then raise your left leg towards the sky. Raise your leg as high as you can and try to hold your big toe with your raised arm. If you're not flexible enough to hold your toe in your hand, it's okay. Just raise it as much as you can and hold the position. Repeat on the other side as well. Number 8, rolling plank. The rolling plank is a strengthening and cardio exercise excellent for your hips, waist, core, and arms. This move can be done on the arms or forearms. It targets your core, glutes, obliques, shoulders, biceps, and wrist flexors and extenders. Start in the forearm plank position. Lift your right arm and twist your body on the left into a side elbow plank. The difference here is that you do not stack your feet on each other. Just turn and come to the forearm position again and then turn to the other side. Without losing your balance, keep turning from side to side. The movement will be something like this. Left to center to right and back to center. Do 20 rolls for one set. Number 9, plank with oblique crunch. Plank with oblique crunch is an intense move for your obliques and abdominals. You can do it on a mat or use a Bosu ball. It's great to target your core, glute, obliques, shoulders, lower back, and biceps. Get into a standard plank position and tighten your abs. Bend your left knee, turn it to the side, and touch your elbow with it. Squeeze your left obliques. Straighten your leg and repeat with the other leg. Repeat 15 times on each side to complete one set. Rest for 25 seconds and repeat 2 more times. Number 10, plank with leg lift. Starting in a full plank position on your hands, keep your hips steady and abs engaged as you lift one leg up, squeezing your glutes on that side. Hold for a second and then switch to lift the other leg. The legs don't have to lift very high. Instead, think about reaching them back and further away from you. Alternate for 10 repetitions on each side. Number 11, plank jack. There's a jumping motion in this variation that brings dynamic movement to the plank and an added cardiovascular challenge. Start in a high plank with your palms flat on the floor, hands shoulder-width apart, shoulders stacked directly above your wrists, legs extended behind you, and your core and glutes engaged. Jump your feet out to the sides and back in like jumping jacks. Keep your hips stable as you jump your feet in and out. Continue until you're tired. Apart from planks, another great exercise to add are squats. Learn more about the health benefits by watching Do Squats Every Day and see what happens to your body. Now back to plank variations that will give you six-pack abs in no time. Number 12, plank up-down. Start in a high plank with your palms flat on the floor, hands shoulder-width apart, shoulders stacked directly above your wrists, legs extended behind you, and your core and glutes engaged. Lower your right arm down so that your forearm is on the floor. Then do the same with your left. You should now be in a forearm plank position. Place your left hand back on the floor to extend your arm and follow with your right so that you end back in a high plank. That's one rep. For the next rep, start by lowering your left arm and following with your right. Do 2 sets of 10 reps each. Number 13, lateral plank walk. Start in a high plank position with your palms flat on the floor, hands shoulder-width apart, shoulders stacked directly above your wrists, legs extended behind you, and your core and glutes engaged. Take a step to the right, starting with your right hand and right foot, and following with your left hand and left foot, maintaining a plank position as you move. This is one rep. Do a set in one direction and then repeat the same number of reps in the opposite direction. Try doing 3 reps on each side for best results. Number 14, reach plank. Start in a forearm plank with your palms flat, hands shoulder-width apart, shoulders stacked directly above your elbows, legs extended behind you with your feet together, and your core and glutes engaged. This is the starting position. Reach forward with your hand and tap the floor in front of you. Return your forearm to the starting position. Reach forward with your left hand and tap the floor in front of you. Return to the starting position. This is one rep. Do 2 sets of 10 reps each. While planks are great for strengthening your core and abs, there are other exercises that you should be doing regularly if you want to tone your whole body. These workouts are great for helping you lose weight in a short time. Learn more of what we're talking about by watching 6 resistance band exercises that change your body in 4 weeks, or 11 CrossFit exercises that will transform your body in 30 days. So go ahead and watch one or both videos if you want a great-looking body but don't have a lot of time. What plank variation is the most difficult for you? Let us know in the comment section below.